can only imagine what it will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I will do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Sing hallelujah. Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. When all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
Good afternoon. Thank you for choosing to come today on this day, February 5, 2022, to honor and celebrate the life of Lori Lynn Gardner. If you happen to be viewing online, you're viewing the Lori Lynn Gardner funeral. I would like to give another comment to you. If you happen to have one of these little gadgets or gizmos, might want to find it in the off mode or in the at least the silent mode today as we talk about Lori's life. Thank you for coming today. Though we're few in number, that does not mean that we don't have many memories and we have glad hearts to share in Lori's life. And so I'm glad that you're here today. Would you join me in a word of prayer as we begin this service? Gracious Father, Almighty God, thank you for the days that you have given to us. This is a Saturday, and no doubt a number of our Saturdays we do other things, but today we're here to celebrate Lori's life. Thank you for her life and the impact that she has had on a number of us. And we thank you, God, that we can gather in this way and share. May the things that are shared here today give you honor, and may it also increase our enjoyment and understanding of Lori's life. I pray, God, that you would comfort all who are here, friends, family, some who are watching online. May you give them the comfort that they need today. You are the God of all comfort. And so, God, we pause for these moments at the beginning to say, oh, gracious God, come and be our all in all today and be our strength. We pray all this in Jesus' name. Amen. Please hear the words from the psalmist, a very familiar psalm. Some of you might know, and if you want to repeat them quietly in your heart as I recite them verbally, feel free. Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The family has chosen this song in which to listen to. We were able to get Alan Jackson in the house today. Well, he won't be in the house, but you'll be able to listen to his voice and hear the wonderful words of Amazing Grace. Please listen.
bright shining as the sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
I enjoyed that song. I hope you enjoyed it as well. What a wonderful voice, and I'm glad we're able to hear Amazing Grace. I wanted to read to you today the obituary. If you happen to get a folder on your way in, it's on the back side of the folder. You do not have to follow along if you don't want to. You can just listen. I will read it, and I will trust I will do a good job of reading this, the best that I can am able to do. But if you want to hear the obituary, here is how it goes. Lori Lynn Gardner, age 58, of Rapid City, passed away on January 23rd at Monument Health. She was born August 30, 1963, at Newark Wayne Community Hospital. She graduated in June of 1981 from North Rose Wolcott High School. She kept busy by working at Glider Oil and Connolly's Cove, Mott's, ASI, Ellsworth Air Force Base, BX, and Walmart. But most importantly, she enjoyed being Shayla's mom and Betty's daughter. When Lori was in grade school, she won the Apple Harvest Queen Festival Award. She loved after-school activities such as roller skating, which a number of you younger ones don't know what that is, but it's like rollerblading, at Wolcott Elementary School on the gymnasium floor with Ron. Who was better, Ron, you or she? Should I ask that question? She was better. Okay. Thanks for being honest today. Could she go backwards? No. Could you? Okay. Yeah, some could. That was impressive. Her high school years were filled with going to concert with her friends. Lori also took ballet lessons for several years and could still do the poses. She loved state fairs, rides, and all the attractions which continued into her later years. Lori met and married John W. Gardner on December 2nd of 1995, and their daughter Shayla was born. She enjoyed cooking, and a couple family favorites are tuna noodle casserole and cheeseburger soup. However, her tuna noodle secret, which I think is a great secret, was chicken instead of tuna myself. You might like tuna, and that's okay. Lori collected recipe books and magazines to share with her mom. I think it should have said Lori collected many, many, many recipe books and magazines. This is correct, but I understand she had a lot of recipe books. She loved getting the family together for special occasions, holidays, and birthdays. The evening would include playing poker. She is survived by her husband, John Gardner, her daughter, Shayla Gardner, her brother, Ron, and wife, Liz Countryman, nephew, Patrick, and wife, Jen Byerly, niece, Tegan, and Dom Schuler, father-in-law, Jack Gardner, and Donna, sister-in-laws, Belinda and Mark Viola. Is Belinda here today? Okay. I have a sister named Belinda, so when I see that name, it's like, that's not a real common name. So, Charity Gardner, nephew Michael Viola, great aunt Midge DeMarco, numerous aunts, uncles, and cousins. She was preceded in death by her father, Richard Countryman, stepfather, Stanley Doyle, mother, Betty Doyle, uncles, Benjamin Sears and Tink, Robert Sears, Pete Sears, numerous aunts, uncles, and cousins. I have some remembrances that were put together, I think, by Liz and Shayla. Is that correct? Or more Liz, more Shayla, or Shayla, Liz? Just both of you? Both of you here. Okay. And I have the privilege of sharing those today. Anytime we were at Lori's, the TV would be on. Hallmark, crime stories, and when Court TV was on the air, that would be on all the time. Did she like Judge Judy, or was she a... No, the live stuff. Okay, yeah. When we played cards, especially poker, the tunes would be blasting. When Lori would go to Ron and Liz's house, she enjoyed long walks with Angel, who is Rambo's sister Lori's dog. They are English Springer Spaniels. Ron and Liz have an aquarium that Lori loves so much, but it took Shayla winning a fish at the Central States Fair. She got him an aquarium 55 gallons for one tiny goldfish. Lori enjoyed Christmas and watched Hallmark for all 3 months that it aired, and she also took up all the space in the DVR with Christmas movies. Lori and her mom loved going to Books a Million, where Lori and Betty would both have a raspberry coffee and look through their cooking magazines. When we all went boating, Lori wanted to be the first to drive, and after driving around for a while, she wanted to sit and fish. One of her last wishes was to get the family together for a big burger and brat cookout. Lori would never say goodbye. She would say something like this. Some would say, "See you in a little bit," and Lori would say, "A little bit," or "See you later, alligator," and she would respond, "See you in a while, crocodile." And the final remembrance was, "See you in a little bit." Thank you, Liz and Shayla, for taking time to put those remembrances down. I want to share with you from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verses 13 to 18. I hope that this encourages your heart. "But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by a word from the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the sound of the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will always be with the Lord. Therefore, encourage one another with these words." We're gathered here today to celebrate the life of Lori Gardner, and I'm thankful for each one of you taking time out of your schedules today to come. The psalmist says in Psalm 39, "Show me, O Lord, my life's end and the number of my days. Let me know how fleeting is my life. You have made my days a mere handbreadth. The span of my years is nothing before you. Each man's life is but a breath." As I think on Lori's life, and I think of each of our lives, because we're here today, I ask the question, what are we doing with each of our days? Obviously, today you're here. And according to my calculations, Lori lived 21,330 days. 21,330 days. It doesn't seem like that's not enough in my mind. But the Word of God says that the Lord knows each of our days, and we must be ready to meet our Maker. 1963 was when Lori was born. There's a couple of you that doesn't seem that long ago for some of you. For others of you, it's longer than you've been alive. What happened in 1963? Let me share with you a couple of things that happened in 1963. Fruit Loops came into existence in 1963. Don't know if you had a bowl of Fruit Loops this morning, but 1963 was the year. I don't know if you've ever seen or been a part of the St. Louis Arch. Anybody ever been to the St. Louis Arch? that was started construction in 1963. I believe it finished in 1965, but as long as Lori was alive was when that was started. In 1963, zip codes were introduced. It seems like just an everyday part of our lives with zip codes, but 1963. And then a very familiar thing that happened in 1963, and I believe November of the year, there was a president by the name of John F. Kennedy that was assassinated. What are you doing with each of your days? On one of the days that Lori was alive, you were born, Shayla. You don't remember that day, but if your mom was here, she would remember that day, and we do mourn for your loss, Shayla. What did Lori do with each of her days? Well, she worked at Glider Oil. I understand she worked at the commissary. She worked at Duffy Mott's. She had a smile. She enjoyed laughter. She loved TV. She loved animals. Actually, one of the guys who's helping in the back today said, well, she liked dogs. I said, yep, because if you notice the video that was played, there were several dogs there. She loved songs, and she played a number of card games. She enjoyed fishing, and she enjoyed cooking. As Shayla and Ron and Liz and I were talking, it was talked about cheeseburger soup. And we have cheeseburger soup in our house, and I think it's wonderful. I'm assuming it was wonderful as well. She had, as a reminder, many, many recipe books and cutouts from magazines. She enjoyed a very familiar gathering here in the Black Hills, Sturgis, and typically would get a t-shirt to honor that time of her time in Sturgis. What do you do with each day? What do I do with each day? As we look on Lori's life, I think if she was here, and now the perspective that she has, she would say, make the most of every day. To put some things away that are holding you back, and to add to your life some things that are wholesome and healthy and valuable. It's a time for us actually to kind of evaluate our lives a little bit. What's going to be missed from Lori? Well, her cooking's going to be missed. Cookouts. Her smile. She was a joy to be around. Ron told me today that as she was in the hospital very ill, that when they would play music, she'd move her shoulder a little bit. Missed that. Many times when we have a loved one that's passed away, we just miss that person's presence. It's one of those things, if I may say, you don't miss somebody's presence typically until they're gone. And then you'd like, ah. And so I encourage you, maybe there's somebody in your life that you need to just reach out to, even today, before your head hits the pillow, that you just are thankful for them, and you just want to let them know. There might be somebody in your life, it might be a friend from a long time ago, maybe a family member you haven't spoke to in recent days, and you just want to say, you know what, I just want to let you know, I'm thankful for you. Because it's on days such as this, we say, if we would have had one more day. I think also in these moments, it's a great question to ask of where is God in each of your lives? We are told, according to God's word, that he wants to comfort each of us, and he does. Here's what the psalmist says. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Though the earth give way, and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, and the mountains quake with their surging. It's on such a day that we evaluate what we're doing with our lives, what's happened, and what will happen in our lives. I want to remind you, I think you know this, but God is a God of love. At times, you may have felt this, and you may feel this, especially with regards to Lori, being frustrated and mad with God a little bit and saying, well, why already? I mean, come on, we want to hold on to Lori. I may not understand, but God's in control. And at times it may seem surreal. I don't know if each of you have lost someone close to you before. But when you do, it's like, I'm not going to call that person. Sometimes death has a way of taking its time. And I hope that everyone here leaves every day with no regrets, and at the end of the day, having peace in your heart. I truly believe that if Lori was here today, she would want us all to take an inventory of our lives and say, are we going the right way? Are we going the wrong way? Where are we at? Obviously, I'm a pastor, or if you didn't know I was a pastor, I'm a pastor, and I'm a pastor of this church here, and it's not about a church that you attend. I think church is a great thing. If you don't have a church home, come here. We'd love to have you. But it's not about a church or a church home. It's about having a relationship with Almighty God. And you may say, well, I'm a good guy. I'm a nice lady. It has to do with a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. The scripture tells us in Philippians that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. The Word of God also says that if we confess with our mouth and believe in our heart that Jesus is Lord, we will be saved. See, we're never good enough. We need God help on our side and Jesus in our lives. God allows times like this to happen in our life to just refocus, to focus on what's really important. And many times we really come together in these moments. And there's a purpose for this life, and there's a purpose for the afterlife as well. And the scripture tells us this, that if we are following Jesus, that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And that's what we all want, isn't it? We all want to go to heaven. We don't want to go to the alternative. And so may you and I, before each of us and our heads hit the pillow tonight, may we have peace with Almighty God. I think Lori would want that for all of us here. I believe that each one of you, in your own way, will miss Lori. There'll be something in your heart. Maybe it's just you're here because of a family member and you're a friend. Or maybe you are a family member and maybe you remember Lori real well. Maybe you don't remember her much. But each of us will be impacted by this. And so I pray that God will minister to you today. I want to pray for you. And then following my prayer, I would like, if you're willing, for you to recite the Lord's Prayer with me. The Lord's Prayer will be on the screen as well. If you don't happen to know it, or sometimes some of the words get kind of messed up a little bit, so if you want to read those out loud, you don't have to say the Lord's Prayer with me out loud, but I will say it, and if you want to say along with me, then that will be wonderful. Then following that, I'll give some further instructions. But would you pray with me, please? Heavenly Father, you are so gracious to us because you have given us life and breath today. I don't understand all of life, but I do understand that as I awaken with my eyes every morning, that you are right there beside me. You're right beside all of us, actually. And you have brought us into the world as nothing that we've been able to do. I thank you for my parents that came together and they had me as a son. And I just ask God that as every one of us here has life and breath, that we would give all of our lives, give all of our breaths to you, and that we would serve you faithfully. Thank you for Lori's life. Seems like it might have been cut short a little bit too soon in my mind. But God, there's a reason behind everything, and we trust you and we believe you. Thank you for the happy moments that many had with Lori, whether it be in a cookout or fishing or on a boat or just listening to the TV with her. God, I just pray that you would comfort again each one that's here, the one who's very mournful, the one who is very down, the one who is left wondering. I pray that you would lift them up today and encourage their heart. God, I pray that in a little bit when we leave from this building, that you would encourage each person as they leave and lift them up and encourage them with your presence, because it's your presence that can go with us. Thank you, God, for loving us. Thank you for helping us today. Continue to be with each as they leave, that they may sense your presence in their lives. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. And then we pray as Jesus has taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I want to thank you all for choosing to come again today. In just a couple of moments, there's a song that's written by, or sung by at the very least, Genesis, Your Own Special Way, and that's going to be played. But just as soon as that song is played, I'm going to escort the family out, and then the rest of you can come as well. And we have some treats that we'd love for you to stay and share some memories. Some of you might need to go, but if you're willing to stay for a few minutes and maybe greet whomever, I'm sure that they would be encouraged by that. Thank you for coming today.
Special way. won't you come now? Whoever.